That was LC King with his new song Double X on Beagle Radio. And that was also a tour of a Polish palace in called Boszków. And this is Beagz. Welcome. This is Muddin with Beagz, episode 38. Let's see what we can get into. And doing this research with the Mudflood and the Old World and Tartaria and all the related subjects, it's just kind of funny what you run into these days.
Proceed, Smithers.
Our first issue, sir, is our low productivity and record high worker accident rate.
Any suggestions?
A round of layoffs might wake up the idiots.
We could put caffeine in the water cooler.
Well, those are my ideas. You people don't think, you regurgitate. That's why I promoted someone who's in touch with the workers. You.
I think you mean him, sir.
You, then. How would you improve the worker situation?
Well, sir, for one thing, we had a problem every Tuesday when the cafeteria would serve fish sticks.
Fish sticks? What in blazes are you talking about?
Well, sir, they cut the head off the fish and chop up the rest in the sticks and then put seasoned bread.
I know what fish sticks are! Get to the point!
Well, you only get this tiny little cup of tartar sauce to dip in them, and I always run out.
Will you stop wasting our time, Simpson?
Shut up, Smithers! Can't you see what he's saying? A happy worker is a busy worker. 3 cents worth of tartar sauce could save us thousands of man-hours in labor. I like the cut of your jib, Simpson. Let the fools have their tartar sauce.
Enjoy your tartar sauce, boys. Enjoy! Give me your plate. Don't crowd. Plenty for everybody.
Brilliant.
And I learned a good lesson this Thanksgiving. And that is where I got to watch a mother teach her child about tasting new foods. And so to taste sweet potatoes for the first time, the four-year-old was handed a fork with a dab, and I mean a very small dab, like the head of a pencil dab, on one prong of a fork, and the child put it in its mouth and tasted it.
I don't like it. It doesn't taste good. I don't like it.
So the mother says, okay, well, eat, you know, what you do like on the plate. Okay, so the child has now, thinking she's tasted sweet potatoes and doesn't like it, has no idea really if she likes sweet potatoes or doesn't like sweet potatoes, because she has no idea what it tastes like, because you can't taste nothing when you just get a dab. Same thing with sex. If you had sex for a second, you wouldn't know if you liked it or hated it. Same thing with Mudflood. And this is Butte, Montana, and it was a city that I found while I was studying pavement light, and there were pavement lights in front of these shops here, and when they went in to do some renovation work, they dug the pavement lights out, and they were going to fix the sidewalks, and what they found were underground doors and windows. And coming up here in a second, you're going to see that. And it's a very good example. This is after they dug it out. And that is too. And this right here is an example of a door and window that they found underground, under the pavement light, when they dug it out. So anyways, Butte, Montana. So the point of it is that you need to get more than a dab of Mudflood in order to understand the Mudflood, hence the mudding videos that I do. I hope to bring you more and more and more so you can understand more and more and more. Well, that's enough of that. Beagle, roll them credits. Let's go mudding. got here, 1865, Charleston, South Carolina. This is Archibald McLeish's Vulcan Ironworks on Cumberland Street. Vulcan Ironworks. Okay. That's the Vulcan Ironworks, I'm assuming. Archie McLeish. Weird name. Vulcan Ironworks. And look at this signage they've made. This thing's crazy. That is super cuckoo. Locomotive spring. Double action locomotive spring. Check that thing out. That is wild. That damn thing's got a cannon on it. What in the world? Oh, are we a Mason? I see. Oh, okay. We're getting to the bottom of something here. What the hell is this thing? Is that a palm branch made out of iron? Oh, that's pretty wild. Plow. Wonder what that thing is, man. Okay, let's back out and start again. What we got going here? We got Mr. Contractor's left his sawhorses in the middle of the road. And probably his ride. This is what Mr. Contractor rode to work. This here and this here. This is Mr. Contractor's vehicles that he hooks Fred up to. And Fred is over here taking him a break. Getting him a little bit of water, it looks like, maybe. As Fred and Wilbur. And Fred is the horse that built America. And Wilbur's his cousin. And let's see, we've got arched windows with keystone. Big old, that's a pretty tall door there. Maybe, oh, how's that horse? Maybe 6 feet tall, so 12-foot door. Maybe 15, roughly speaking. Don't write the note. Old gas lamp. Boss man right there. Okay. Bit of diamond symbology there. The wrought iron work. Wrought iron, I believe, is old world. I believe this old wrought iron is definitely leftover remnants. And I need to do a video or something. Go grab this video and do something with it. But I highly suggest going and checking out Streets of Tartaria's, one of his latest videos. I'm sure in the comments he'll pipe in and tell you which video it is. But he goes inside of a structure, a town structure like one of these in Utah. I believe it's Utah. And he goes, and on the outside they have the flat stone headers like this. Okay, but from the research we're doing, it looks like that these flat stone headers were changed over, that they are original arches. And so anyways, he goes in this building and is sitting there talking to a guy, and they're on one of the upper floors. I believe it's a two-story, maybe a three-story building. I think it's a two-story. Anyways, he's up there and he's talking to a guy, and he's inside now, and he looks over and the arch is inside the building. But he clearly remembers filming the outside of the building. It had the flat-headed stone arch, or stone header over the window. And he's like, whoa, you know, like he realized it was like a eureka moment. And we were talking about that today, how interesting it was to find that evidence where the facade on the outside. I'm talking around my ass to get to my elbow. So basically, as he thought and I thought, we thought that they came in and tore the arches out and redid them and put the stone flat headers in. And that doesn't seem to be the case. It seems they just facaded a new layer of brick over and put the facade, the stone header, flat stone header on the outside of the facade. And if you go inside, they're still arched. Now, I don't know if that's the case for every building, but it is. I've seen proof of it. So it's interesting. We need to do more research there. And I'm sure he's going to go dig into that some more, because we're both blown away by that. We both learned something new there. Anyways,
What else we got? We got, oh, this is 1865, also Charleston, South Carolina, ruins of Roman Catholic Cathedral. Otherwise known as a healing center, because they certainly don't heal you in the Roman Catholic cathedrals. Just saying. Not healing nothing. Certainly ain't healing your soul, poor people. Things pretty damaged here. Big old arches. Look at the size of that arch right there. Good grief. I can't even imagine how big that is. I believe this is a sign of old world construction where they put the wood joist into the bricks, into the side of the building. I believe that's old world. I believe when you see that, that's a telltale sign of old world. This is the same church. And this is Cathedral of St. John and St. Finbar, Broad and Laguerre Streets, destroyed in the fire December 1861. So this is some Civil War destruction campaign stuff. And I believe that the Civil War was a campaign to go in and destroy the old world buildings and knock out some of what was here in order to knock down some of the narrative that they had to come up with. I'm not a believer in the Civil War anymore. I don't believe the American Revolutionary War happened either. I mean, just sit back and think a minute. Would you sit there in a line and let somebody fire a musket at your effing head and while you just stood there? And then when they get done, if you ain't dead or, you know, you're not, you know, wounded in some way, shape, or form, you fire back. And you take turns back and forth. Think about that for a second. What kind of fool is going to stand there and take a bullet? They called it an honorable way of doing war and, you know, the gentleman's war. What are you talking about, man? Somebody's firing a projectile at your head and you're not going to duck? I don't think so. I don't believe it. Now, I know I was taught that and you were taught that. Big old portholes here. I believe that these... where they would put clocks here, but I believe there's something else going on here. I don't believe these were originally clocks, and I believe this is some kind of part of the wind catcher system, and I'll put a GIF that shows the wind catcher in the ending, the end credits of this video. These could be mud flood windows here, possible. A world brick. Okay, anyways, let's move on. And we got 1900 Union Trust Building, Detroit, Romanesque Revival Wedding Cake at Griswold and Congress that went up in 1896, came down in 1956. So they tore this one down. It was demolished. Because we need to get rid of these buildings because they're ugly. I mean, we build them grand, yet they're ugly. So let's get them torn down and put something with steel and glass up that is, you know, something that has no character or, you know, artistic value or architectural interest, or, you know, is dull and mundane and looks like, you know, a piece of shit on, you know, city street. And that is Fred. Fred is the horse that built America, in case you didn't know. And what are we gonna find? Buttermilk. Tobacker. Backy, as they call it here. Backy. Got some symbology there, something going on there. Check out that facade right there. Yeah, it's like might be Phoenician shelf though. Got portholes up here. Portholes, I believe, were part of the air conditioning system. And by air conditioning, I don't mean like we have today, you know, your HVAC systems where, you know, you stand in front of it and it blasts cold air in your face. No, it was an air conditioning system. It conditioned the air to a... It would take out the... It would bring in cool air into the input, which would have been the higher, larger input. And the output would take out... The cool air would push the hot air up. It would, because the cool air would be funneled via vortex through the building and down and then back up, and it would push the hot air out of the building, and it would condition the air. Got Tartarian line, 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 Tartarian line. It's a lot of lines. Wall relief of control, shitty ass awning, nice keystone, big ass doors, tiny ass people, old world fire hydrant, mudflood winders, here and here, all around here, in case you wonder what mudflood is. What's a mudflood? Is that, fool? Look it up. Let's see. Well, we got more crappy awnings. If you see crappy awnings, we need this. These are called coins, spelled with a Q. And I believe these are part of the free energy system. Just my thinking. I don't think I'm the only one that thinks that. Phoenician shells, laurel leaf of controls right here. La-dee-da, la-dee-da. I think that's a symbol right there. Even though it's plain and simple, I believe it's a symbol. Phoenician wave right there. Let's see it more right there too. So a lot of Phoenicianists on this building. That's a word, I just made that up. Put that down in the dictionary. Yep, okay. I tend to do that. La-dee-da-dee-da-da. What are we gonna find? Find me something good. Big ass doors. Big ass windows. Why would you build big ass doors and big ass windows? This is something this is a phenomenon when it comes to this, is the three doors. I heard old Levy talking about three doors the other day on cathedrals, and that's actually very accurate, is that there's three doors a lot of times. Why were there three doors? And a lot of times the middle one seems to be the largest door. Now, aesthetically, okay, that makes sense, but what if it's got some sort of function? What if maybe the giants went through the bigger door and the many people like us went through these doors? Now, obviously, these have been modified. But what if there was a bigger ass door here and the giants went in here and that was their way of getting in, and then we had our door? Because it would make sense. It's all logic. 1904, Portland, Maine, looking down Congress Street from Congress Square. Roosevelt and Fairbanks. Okay, nobody cares. You're all crooked anyways. And looks like that's a grate into the underground there, and there, and there, and there. And the grates were pavement light. This was 1904, would have been around the time the pavement light was really starting to get popular. But it would be, the grates were the first thing. And they sucked. So the water would just run right in them. The ladies' heels would get caught in them. People would drop things in them. They were awful. Grates were stupid. So they got rid of the grates pretty quick. That was a bad idea. Pavement lights were a little better idea, but they were still a bad idea too. They ended up failing as well. Ventilation underground right here, 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 here. All that's ventilation into the underground. And gloves, jewelry, florist. Okay. It's good to read the signs, because the signs can help you. There is Fred. Fred is always on the job, working hard, getting it done, building America. And he's kind of like Santa Claus. And there's his cousin Wilbur, hanging out, getting the rest of it done. Because, I mean, let's just be honest. We all know, and I don't think I have to say it, but Fred, you know, he had to have help, because there's no way that really, I mean, it's fun to say Fred built America, but we all know that Fred had some help. You know, he had the trains help him, you know, with the trolley tracks and blah, 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 and blah, you know, they had carts and you know, trains and what have you that would help out. But yes, Fred had help. So I thought that was obvious, though. I hate to really say the obvious. There's Ether Finial up there. Pyramid symbology. These towers back here. Ether tower. Ether antenna right there. Got a cupola up here. Probably a wind catcher. That's probably a wind catcher too. Boston steamers. That's overhead electric trolley. See what we got going on over here. There's boss man right there. You got a winder into the underground right there. Another one right there. Another one right there. Another one right there. Another one right there. Excuse me, fella. Didn't mean to circle your junk. These things happen when we're in the hot pursuit of Mudflood. Da 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 da. We need the Mudflood 5-0. Da 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 da. Mudflood. Okay. And we got a tourist field right here. And what else? See, there's that symbol again. I believe that's a symbol, even though it's very plain. Sometimes the plainest things are, you know, that look very simple, or actually that's probably a wind catcher right there. The air would come in here and it would circulate down through the building. So that's, and that window right there could be part of the ventilation system. I don't know. Maybe it might be these. It's like, it seems like they have kind of multiple, there's multiple parts to the wind catcher. You have the input, you have the output, you have the portholes that allow where you can regulate how much air goes into a certain area of the building. And then you have ways of shutting off dust and, you know, sometimes they went into the ground. The air went all the way down in the ground, got down to the water. They would have water down there and it would cool the air and it would create an air conditioning effect. More like today where we run cold air, you know, we run air over cold water and it cools it down. That's the same kind of effect. That's a lot of wiring. Anywho, moving on. We got 1910 Mott Street in New York's Little Italy, now Chinatown. Okay. And my eyes drawn right here. The coho covers right here. And we got pavement light. We got an entrance to the underground. More pavement light there. More pavement light there. There's Fred and Wilbur getting America built, because that's what they do. Bowler hat man. Boss man. What else we got? We got Pooper Scooper Man right here. Anybody's looking for Pooper Scooper Man? Some people do. I don't know. Hey, teach his own. Everybody got a little freak in them. That's okay. Get your freak on. Got entrance to the underground. When you see these wrought iron railings here, those are red flag for entrances to the underground. See, there's one right there. That's underground. And what's underground? That's right, the basements. Why is there basements underground that you're using as storefronts in a time where, well, they didn't have, you know, electricity? Because these were built prior to 1910 now. This isn't, you know, it's not like they popped this up in 1910 and all of a sudden they had electric. Oh, let's run electric. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. It took a little while. I'm just saying. I mean, let me give you an example. Anybody that lives in New York right now will tell you they didn't get cable vision for a long time. Matter of fact, I believe they were the last place, New York City, I believe they were the last place to get cable vision because it was so difficult to run the cables in New York City for cable vision, for people to have cable. So, you know, you have shows like MTV, which were filmed in New York, and people in New York couldn't even watch them. Think about that. And so in the 80s, when I'm sitting at my house watching MTV shown, you know, from MTV News, you know, shown from New York, well, the people in New York weren't watching that. What we got here? I can't read that. What is that? What kind of language is that? Hell, I don't know. I don't know what kind of language that is. To let, store and basement. Okay, we're going to rent out the basement. And all these fire escapes are something that we added. They weren't on these buildings originally. No, no, no. I mean, look how bad they look. I mean, if it looks bad, obviously we did it. Practical Shoemaker Repair. There's Wilma. That's Fred's girl. That's his lady friend. Okay. What the hell? So, wait a minute. Okay, there's Pooper Scooper Man, and that is Pooper Scooper Man's cart. And Wilma is taking her a bite out of what's in that Pooper Scooper Man's cart. I'm just saying. Everybody gets a little freaky in them, I guess. It's okay. We got to sell cabbages. So we got a little street vendor there. We got a barbershop pole, which is, I think, whenever I see barbershop poles, I look down, which I can't see down there, but I bet you that barbershop's in the underground, which makes zero sense to me why you would put a barbershop in the underground in a time where you didn't even have, you know, electric lights. 1920, Times House, 922 New York Avenue. So, well, just another mud flutter, you know, in case you need one of them. Shoe repair in a mud flutter. Shoe repair while you wait. Above the mud flutter. Something JR renting in a mud flutter. I mean, there's that symbol again, that circle. Okay, it's just a plain circle. That means something. There it is again. See? Whatever that is, it means something. See, there's a coin. Okay. Keystone. I believe these doodads were technology. Maybe a capacitor for the free energy. And the energy would have been stored in the bricks. And that's a flat earth asterisk. In case you need one of those. And a flat earth asterisk. Yes, I know it's a sign. It's not as big a deal. But it is a flat earth asterisk. It's in 1920. And I'm going to claim it. Because I believe that they show you this symbol in our world today. Just as much as they showed it to you in the architecture of yesterday. And this, the horizontal bar here represents the flat earth. And the vertical represents the north-south magnetic poles, and then the X represents the torus field that's surrounding the flat earth. And yes, I do believe it is a flat earth. I do believe that one day the globers will eat the dirt off our shoes and will be very apologetic for being such morons. But that's okay, because I was one of those globers up until a few years ago. And I have now pulled my head out of my ass and have got it all figured out with that. So it comes down to using your freaking mind and not let Google Earth tell you what you're seeing. So, you know, that's one way to do it. Look at the horse shit that is this staircase right here. I mean, it's just so stupid. That obviously was not designed that way. Neither was this one. It don't even make sense. We got Mudflood Winters there. I don't know if I pointed those out. I figured somebody would, you know, have told you about that by now. But anyways, we got 1935 King William County, Virginia. Waterville, vicinity of Sweet Hall. Built by Tidewater planter James Ruffin in 1794. So I would say that the 1794 time frame is just some made up bullshit. And this, I'm just attracted to this right here. What is that? What is that going on? Okay, it's going underneath, got, you know, what they call fireplaces. And then we got this here, got arched windows there, which would represent old world, or, you know, signify old world. And then you've got this concrete or plaster, or not plaster, stucco, you know, kind of stuff over the brick here, which has already fallen off by 1935, and, you know, obviously trying to seal the building somehow. We've got Mudflood windows over here that have obviously been modified with louvered windows, and this right here, this little fencing here, is crappy, but when I see something like that, it makes me want to look in the hole there, see what's there, because there might be something there. Those stairs do not go with that house. I'm sorry. That dog don't hunt. That dog hunts. That dog don't hunt. That hot. Yeah. That, see, that's what a hunt dog looks like. That is not what a hunt dog looks like. That dog don't hunt. And if you don't know what that means, then you're not from the South. And you basically just stay up there and where you are and not know what you're talking about. Because I don't need to explain Southern philosophy. Alexandria, Virginia, circa 1926, Dr. Fairfax, home Ford Motor Company. Okay, Ford Motor Company. Okay, I guess the guy worked for Ford Motor Company. I don't know. But I see Mudflood Winders, some little midget dude, more Mudflood Winders right there. We added all this piping here. That's a beautiful window right there. That is really cool. That's pretty too. Wow, look at that arch. Very pretty. Very pretty. Simple, but nice. That's a pretty car. That's a nice car. He's got two spare tires on that car. Looks like Mudflood Winters back here. Got ivy growing up beside. I believe we added the gutters too. I believe that's an invention we came up with. Alexandria, Virginia, circa 1926, home of Light Horse Harry Lee Ford Motor Company. Okay, I don't know what the Ford Motor Company business is, but anywho, is that the same house? No. Okay. Got more Mudflood Winters there. Well, don't that look horse shitty right there? I don't know. Weird arch windows. Keystones. More keystones. And that's a flat earth asterisk. And you will see it everywhere. You'll see this thing in your damn dreams by the time I'm done with you. Yeah, go on, laugh. He'd be like, ha ha ha, what's he talking about? That crazy Beaks, I tell you. Yeah, laugh at me now. I'm telling you right now, there's going to be a point in your research. And you're going to, at one point, you're going to realize that this damn symbol right here is important. And you're going to be like, damn. That crazy fool won't crazy. Oh, what do I do with that? And we've got amplifiers at Boiling Field, 1921. Two giant horns with ear tubes, evidently designed to listen for approaching aircraft. Okay, and or aliens. Okay. Yep. That makes sense. Yep. I don't even. What do you say about that? That's a big ass building back there. I could say that. I don't know. These things are just strange. I mean, you know, there's quite a few pictures out there about these technologies in that time. I guess without the radar, they came up with weird ways of doing things, but. Gosh, that's so strange. Okay, another view of Mott Street, New York's Little Italy, now Chinatown. Oh, okay, so another Chinatown in 1910. And I'm immediately drawn to the big-ass hole in the ground because, well, that makes sense right there. I mean, just really take that in, how that makes sense that you're designing a building and you're going to design a freaking hole. A hole. That's not even a staircase. That's a hole. That I think you just jump in and out of that hole to get into your house. That right there could be pavement light. It's hard to tell. it has some telltale signs of pavement light, even though it's not standard issue. And this right here is probably pavement light as well. And, you know, that's Mudflood hole. And Mudflood hole. And, I mean, this is just crazy here. Drugstore. Is the drugstore upstairs or, I don't know, down? I don't know. And we've got a coal hole cover right here. Another one right here. But this is what I was talking about. When you see these wrought iron fences, you see how one is for the underground and one is for the store. Okay. Same here. This is for the underground. Okay. Now, why they did the one, like, why do they need one in between, like, this one right here? Why do they need that right there? I don't know. I can't say. It's a bit odd. That's Boss Man right there. And we got more underground right there. I mean, there's just a whole bunch of underground right here. I mean, there's just a lot going on under there. This is probably the opposite view that we're looking at, because there's that two-let sign. That might be exactly where we're just looking from the opposite direction. Anyways, I'm not sure. Doesn't matter. It's still cool. Same area. There's the Phoenician lady right there, it looks like. Hard to tell, though. Look how ornate these buildings are. Yeah, that's Phoenician lady. Yep. I believe that's a Taurus right there. I believe that's technology. There's that symbol, that circle symbol. I'm not sure what the circle symbol means. You know, if you got a circle with a dot in it, it's the circumpunct, which stands for, you know, the creator. But what a circle with nothing in it stands for, I don't know. There's the Vesica Pisces right there. And that's the you know, basically the joining of the male and the female, or the male and the female energies. There's a diamond symbology. You got the Vesica Pisces here with four around it, which is interesting. So that's symbology. I see this a lot, this symbol right here, and this N incorporated into the design work. I see that quite often in my research. I see this actually so often. I actually call it, in my own research, in my own mind, the flower of life 4L, which means nothing if you know what the flower of life is, understand the flower of life. But it reminds me of the flower of life when you hook a bunch of these together in a pattern. It reminds me of the flower of life. Matter of fact, it can look, on first glance, it can look very similar to the flower of life. So that's why I call it the flower of life 4L. And I don't even remember why I call it L. I don't know. Four leaf, that's what it is. This has been so long since I've been doing this stuff, I forget my own research. I called this the flower life 4L for four leaf. You've just been in the mind of a madman. How do you like that? And we got Pilsner beer. Okay. Interesting little symbol there. Look at that symbology there. Oriental Hall. Got the wood stove crackling tonight. It's a nice cold night tonight. I like the cold. It's good for you. We got April 1865. Ruins of the state arsenal at Richmond showing stacked and scattered ammunition. And if you know your history, the story with Richmond is that when the Union soldiers were coming, that they decided to blow up the town, the city, and as they were retreating. And so the story is they, you know, burned their own city down so that the Union didn't get it. Otherwise known as horseshit story. Basically, you know, if you believe that, you'll pretty much believe anything. And these are, I supposedly, leftover, you know, from the explosion. Now, is it possible that they set it on fire and blew it up? yeah, sure, why not? I could go with that, possibly. But more importantly, why they blew it up? Did they blow it up because the Union was coming? No. No, 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 no. They were ordered to blow it up because they had to get rid of Richmond. They had to get rid of some of these towns and cities because they didn't. There was just too many that they couldn't write enough narrative. It couldn't be done. And look at these stacks of bricks right here. I mean, that's kind of weird, right? You got all these bricks lying on the ground, yet you got stacks. I mean, it's just strange, right? All these cannonballs and shot, and it's unbelievable. But yeah, I just don't, I don't believe that, this official story is worth a hoot. What we got back here in the background? Okay, alright. And we got April 1865, Washington, District of Columbia, Sanitary Commission Storehouse, and adjoining houses at 15th and F Streets Northwest. As always, the pictures are in the description, and you can go and look at these photographs on your own and do your own thinking, which is basically what you should be doing anyways. I'm just trying here to help point it out to you so you can, you know, kind of show you, okay, give you a kind of point you in the right direction. And then you have to figure it out from there and do your own thinking and figure out what you believe, what you think, and do your own thinking, because it's, you know, my thinking ain't worth a damn. You know, your thinking to you is what's important. We've got Mudflood here, Mudflood here, Mudflood here, Mudflood here, Mudflood here. Okay, if you want to see Mudflood, it's right there. More Mudflood, more Mudflood. That's a cellar door. Okay. Yep, you've been told that, so have I. But now you need to do your own thinking. And there's Fred. He's got messed up on the negative. Poor thing. But Fred is right there. Fred is the horse that built America, in case you didn't know. You probably know if you've watched any of my shows. I've told you time and time again, old Fred, he's important. Old Fred, everybody, people love Fred. Old Fred, he gets a lot. He gets more comments than I do sometimes, I believe. Feel free to leave a comment in the comment section saying hello to Fred. I'll pass the word along. He Fred reads the comments. You know, he can read. Fred learned a lot in his days of working for the man, moving all this around, getting all this brick set up. Fred learned a whole bunch of things. Arlington Brewing Company, circa 1920. Brewing Company. We need a brewing company that looks like that. With big ass clocks that are expensive. Pyramids. Ether finials. Ether antenna. Right there. Look at the... What in the world? That is just strange right there. Very interesting. I don't know what in the world, that's really odd right there. I mean, I would say we built this metal stack right here going up, pipe stack. But that top is suspect. I don't know. That's kind of weird. Smokestack is not a smokestack. Why would you make your smokestack so elaborately? It don't make sense. It's too elaborate for a smokestack. Yep. That doesn't make sense. Sorry. Arched windows. I mean, come on, man. Look at this, the quality of this building, right? And then look at this horseshit gate. Now, who built what? I'll wait. Do, 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 do. Mr. Contractor got the contract to build that gate. Mr. Contractor, you can start a new channel, but you're still a douche. And we got big ass door here for, you know, this little fella, because he needs a big ass door to get his tiny little ass through. dab. I don't know what that says. I can't tell. And they would bring the hay in through here, through these upper door windows right here, these doors right here. A lot of times, do you believe in... Hey, it's the NBC Peacock. Arched windows. That looks like it's got a glass roof up there. That's interesting. That is just pretty right there. Very pretty. Pyramid up here. The finial. You got to look close. Something weird right there in that area. Can't rightly tell what's going on there. Something weird over here. Okay. And we got August 1908. An enforced rest. Harry Swope. No idea. Okay. That doesn't make any sense. Enforced rest. Okay. I don't know. The guy's resting on the chair. Whatever. I don't know. Harry Swope, age 15. 426 Elm Street, Newport, Kentucky. And I just thought this was interesting. Show you a little bullseye pavement light. These were the original pavement lights here. And, well, actually, I take that back. These are second generation of this form of pavement light. Because see these raised nubs here? These raised nubs were actually an addition that they made to these pavement lights after they first put them out. Because when they first put them out, they did not have the raised nubs. And two things would happen. One, they would be very slick when it would rain. If people hit these things, it was like ice. So the nubs were put on there for safety. Number two, when ladies would hit the the glass here with their... That's glass, y'all. When the ladies would hit the glass with their heel, they could pop out and then they would leak. So they put these nubs on there also so the ladies' footwear would have less of a chance to push through, because they would be more up on the nub as opposed to flat on them. That's ventilation into the underground. Check out that vase back there. Fine groceries, fruits, and nuts. Got ventilation to underground right there. There's more pavement light right there. So just a simple photograph like this and you can see a lot of neat things. And we got August 1911, New Bedford, Massachusetts. A group of workers in the Butler Mills. Kate McCormick, 10 Cleveland Street. I don't know who Kate McCormick is. We got ivy growing up the side of the building. And we got Mudflood window here and Mudflood door there. You see it goes into the ground because that makes sense. And we got some folks here. Arched doorway there. That's interesting how this door is squared off, but then you get inside and we have an arched doorway. So it makes me think that this was probably modified here. There's some interesting brickwork there. That's probably a ventilation into the underground right there. So that's that, y'all. Boston circa 1904, Hotel Thorndike, Boyston and Church Street. Hope I said that right. And we got Fred. Fred is on the job getting the building of America done. And we got Mudflood Winders on the bottom here, because that makes sense to someone in a third world country that's never seen or heard of intelligence. And we got more Mudflood winners. We got horseshit stairs that we added. Get your clothing here. Got Mudflood winners and Mudflood winners and Mudflood winners. Everywhere Mudflood, Mudflood, Mudflood. Look at this big ass iron grate over the windows. That's crazy. Wonder what they got in there. Must be a bank. I don't know. A trust company. Huh. One, two. That could... It's kind of hard to see, but you might could make a strange case of that being a flat earth asterisk right there. Blanchard King and Company. That's a weird word that's always bothered me. Sanitary. I never have really understood why they used the word sanitary in like names of businesses. I always thought that was weird. This is beautiful facade work. You get up under there, it's brick. That, I mean, come on. Mr. Contractor, need a quote on that right there, please. Go on and have that on my desk by the afternoon tomorrow. Thank you, Mr. Contractor. That's right. We're going to get some Mudflood doors and winter's belt around here. I bet that's a door right there. Because see, you got a window right there. I bet that's a door. There's Mudflood winters everywhere. I mean, you just look around, do a 360, you're going to see Mudflood winters. RX symbol there. Get your jugs. Arched winders. That's some kind of symbology there. That's odd looking. Boy, that's done there. Look at that brickwork, man. Well, I bet you being a brick mason building these buildings back in the old world was good money. You was in the money. You was going to Sizzler. We going to Sizzler. We going to Sizzler. Anybody seen White Men Can't Jump? We going to Sizzler. If you ain't ever seen that movie, you got to watch. You got to check that movie out. It's an old movie. It's old school, but it's funny as hell. I got reminded of that movie today in a conversation, and I went back and watched a clip, and boy, that movie's funny. That movie. I mean, for just such a stupid little movie, it really was funny, I have to say. It's interesting, the brickwork here. Like, something's happened. Like, they've had to fix it or repair it somehow. Damn, look at that big-ass building back there. That thing's huge. Very pretty. Okay. Got Buffalo, New York, 1901, unloading ore from whaleback carrier. Okay, so that's a whaleback carrier. I've seen these ships before. They look like submarines that basically are on sea level. I don't know. I believe these lighthouses are old world. I believe these are part of technology. I kind of look at them like this. What if the ships were powered via free energy and they needed the lighthouses on the coast in order to, it kind of like a Wi-Fi tower where this free energy was being broadcast from here out to sea, so that the ships and the boats out on the coastline up to, you know, probably miles off coastline could get the free energy so they could run their ships and their boats around and do the fishing and the whatever the boating they needed to do. And then maybe once they got out to the open sea, they had to switch over to steam power or something like that. Maybe, you know, maybe that's how it worked. I don't know, just a thought, you know, just kind of running my mouth. Not that I know. I'm just saying. I just find this technology. Look at that technology. I mean, that is high tech for 1901 to me. I mean, that looks complicated to me for 1901. But I mean, what do I know? I don't know. You know, the stories I heard of what it was like in this time period, I just thought it was very primitive that they were, you know, basically lucky to get food on the table. And that, you know, everything was hard to come by. Yet we have technology like this. I mean, this sucker picks something up off of here and then swings over. See, there's the bucket and it's swinging up. And it doesn't, it's weird because it doesn't turn. How does it get over? I don't know, that's weird. Maybe it just picks it up and then, I don't know, it's not making sense to me. So it goes down here and then dumps. What happens when it gets straight up in the air? I don't know, that makes sense to me. Arc light. I don't know. I just thought we were much more primitive in 1900 than I'm finding out. But that's just my ignorance. I mean, you know, I'm just trying to unignorize myself. That's a word, I just made it up. I'm telling you, I should go work for Webster's. And this is circa 1900, Admiral Sampson's family. Young relatives of William T. Sampson, a hero of the Spanish-American War. So another horseshit war. And that's Fred and Wilma. And yes, they change colors. They're color changers. Kind of, Fred and Wilma are kind of like them horses in The Wizard of Oz that change colors. Just saying. And there's our Mudflood Winners in case you ever want to, you know, see Mudflood Winners. I thought I was looking for the horses, but, you know, lo and behold, we found some Mudflood Winners. How about that? Oh, aren't they cute? Do that little tacky old fella. Oh, we gonna go, we gonna ride the horses. Okay, and creepy. Very creepy. Moving on. Got arch windows that look like they've been modified to me's. Anyways, that's that. Moving on. And we got 1900 main altar, Church of Notre Dame, Montreal, Quebec. Yeah, okay, so I went outside old U.S. of A. I couldn't help myself. I saw this picture and I just had to look at it some more. Words escape me when it comes to that. That is just, it's an upside down rose window. Wow. God, look, jeez. Look at that. I mean, talk about sacred geometry. That is just pretty beyond pretty. Damn. I mean, I've seen fine-ass women that didn't look that good. Oh, man. Good grief. What in the world? I mean, that is a machine. You remove all the horse shit statues, okay? Okay, get rid of all that crap. And then you got a machine. That's a machine. They added all the statue crap. Oh, it's a saint. Kiss my ass. I mean, come on. Seriously? Is that a Florida Lee? I mean, you know. I don't know. I can't tell. Kind of looks like a Florida Lee. I mean, this thing is just incredible. Oh, man. Since when did God need you to build anything? You know, God's good. God's got, like, you know, this thing called the universe to play with that, you know, is the glory of God. God's good. God don't need you to build this. Man built this, okay? But man certainly didn't build this to glorify God. God don't need you to glorify it. God's like, I don't need you to build nothing for me. Why do I need you to build anything for me? Come on. God's good. God's good, right? With what God's got, which is, you know, everything. Okay? God's good. You don't have to worry about God. God's taken care of. Okay. I wonder if there's a Mrs. God. You know, I wonder if God likes to, you know, I don't know. I doubt it. What, it might be a Mr. God. Who says God ain't a woman? Who says God's not an it? Who knows what God is? What does it matter? God's God. God is neither a male or a female, or a male energy or a female energy. It's a combination of both. See this arch right here? This arch is sacred geometry representing the Vesica Pisces, which is the combination of both male and female. Okay? This right here. Okay? It's both. It's the coming together of the energies. It's just energy. All's energy. Everything. All you're looking at here is energy. It's just a lower vibrational energy to the point where it stays in place. Okay? Study quantum physics. Regardless of what you believe about quantum physics, I mean, there's something there. Okay? It's debatable about all the different aspects of it. Yes. But it is debatable. It's not like you can just write it off. There's something going on in the quantum physics realm. I mean, this is just horseshit they added. Okay, all this. All these statues, this is all crap. This was a healing center. You'd walk in here and you'd pay your 2 bits and they would say, okay, what's your problem? You're like, my ass hurts. They're like, okay, we'll sit here. And they'd turn the machine on and you'd walk out and your ass wouldn't hurt no more. Just saying. 1903, Sharpers on 6th Avenue, New York. New York City. That's Boss Man right there. I got you. I got you. Don't you worry. I got you, man. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. Go ahead and get all of these things out of the way so we can get in here and see what's going on with the payment light. That's all payment light right there. In case you need payment light. All that payment light. There's Wilma. She's right there. Ain't she a cutie? And what are we gonna see? I believe these are old world ether lights right here. You see these all over the world. This style. These are prism glass. And these were sold by the same companies that made the pavement lights. And these actually would shine the light back into the building. And why did they have to have light going back into the building? There's an unscrubbed cartouche. That's a rarity. Wonder what's on that. There's another one right there. Unscrubbed cartouche, people. You see how easy it would be to scrub that off with a chisel? Just take a chisel, start banging it out, and then polish it out. Boom. Bada bing, bada boom. You know? Easy. Whatever is on there, they could have got rid of. And that's this is what I'm talking about. That's a scrubbed cartouche. Okay? That's an unscrubbed cartouche. Okay? You see the difference? Right there. Same shot. Boom. Scrubbed, unscrubbed, scrubbed, unscrubbed. Any questions? This is Idiot's Guide to Cartouches. Scrubbed, unscrubbed. Unscrubbed, scrubbed. Got it? Get it? Good. Learn it, live it, love it. Okay. Ether antennas up here. Hall. Okay. Shoes. Okie dokie, we got a third rail system, so that would either be pulled by the cable or it would be the electrical conduit that runs underneath the ground. Got an L here, that's a lifted platform for the trolley, torus field right here, and what are we gonna find? We're gonna find a big old dome, got ether antennas up here. There's a scrubbed cartouche right there. Another ether antenna with a stupid flag on it because that makes sense. Go buy your flag. Put it on a flagpole, okay, in high wind and see how long it lasts. Let's see how long that you know, will hold up to any kind of, like, prolonged wind. Okay. Why do you think they have to take the flags down every day at the end of the day? Because they know they can't leave them out too long. Why do they have the ceremony, like in the military, to take down the flag? Because they know the flag's going to get torn up, and when they take it down, before they put it back, a ratty one back up, they can switch out the flag and nobody knows the difference. Think about that. I believe these are technology too, by the way. Just FYI, while I'm running my mouth. Just putting that out there. I'm just saying. Circa 1905, Minneapolis, Minnesota. And Minneapolis is a cool city. I like Minneapolis. I have good memories of going to Minneapolis. Let's see. And definitely gonna find Fred right here. He's that little dot with legs on it. That's Fred. He's the horse that built America. In case you need to know about that. Okay. Big old arch windows, coal hole covers right there. Let's see. That's something right there. Hard to tell what it is though. Coal hole covers right here. All those circles. Arched windows. That's pavement light right there. Coal hole covers there. So that means that that sidewalk is hollow. And what are we gonna find up in Minneapolis? That's pretty. That's very Moorish looking. That style building there. Arched windows back here. That's interesting right there. Coal hole covers here. So that's hollow sidewalk right there. That's all mud flooded. Got something right there. That's a mud flood. There's an entrance. See how that board is going down in the ground right there? And you got coal hole cover right there. Telltale signs of mud flood. In case you need to know what and if there is a mud flood. And then you got horseshit like this. If that ain't mud flood, I don't know what is. Hey, like that. There's one of those old telecommunications, probably for the telegraph. It's like a telegraph pole, and the lines would trunk off this pole here. Here's another one. You can see the lines coming off of it, trunking off. Ba-ba-dip-a-da. That is crazy building right there. Wow. 1905, people. This is probably something to do with a wind catcher. Check this out. It's ether finial up here. Ether fencing, excuse me. Da, 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 da. Smokestacks that ain't smokestacks. They're too pretty, aren't they? Why would you pretty up your smokestack? That doesn't make any sense. If you want to know about, if you want to come to conclusion what I'm saying about smokestacks ain't smokestacks, go watch that Fred Dina. Go look at the guy that does the destruction of the smokestacks and the repair of the smokestacks over in England, and watch that fool climb up those smokestacks and just listen to his philosophy on these smokestacks. And you know, this guy doesn't know about the mud flood, but he just looking, watching him work on these things, it'll come clear to you that the smokestacks are not smokestacks. They're too freaking big to be smokestacks, to make sense why you would build that thing. It just doesn't add up. Owl would be a Tartarian symbol. And how do we know that? Because it was on the flag. Okay, they had a flag that had an owl on it. Okay, that's how we know that. And the more you know. And this is 1907, Indianapolis. We got a panoramic view. The wind, Pennsylvania. Okay. Got pavement light right here. These are coal hole covers up this little right here. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. That little horse, okay, see that little fella right there? He built all this. Do the math on that. I'm serious. Do the math. Look at that. God, what a world. I mean, where do you even start? You just have to take it in. I mean, it's like, and you think about all this is being built all around the world, in every city, in every town, all at the same time. Who built it? Seriously, think about that. Put that in your little computer mind and figure that out. Run your little smartphone on that, see how it comes out. Probably fry it. Old fried smartphone trying to figure out the answer to that question. Where'd all this brick come from? Who's making all this brick in this time frame? Ether antennas up there. Got an onion dome there. Cloaks. Yep. Need me a cloak. Da da da. What we got? That big old dome. Good grief. I mean, this thing is... This is Europe, people. You know, you think... We think that Europe was like the crescendo of architectural design and building. That's horse shit. Okay? We got just as good shit here in America, but it's in a different style. It's not as fancied. Okay? But our construction is on par. I'm sorry, it is. We build shit like that. Big ass obelisk. Okay? Which I believe are part of the free energy system. Got an eagle, which represents the phoenix. Horseshit smokestack. Damn smokestack. Got ether antennas everywhere. If you got a flagpole, just substitute ether antenna, because it ain't no damn flagpole. And then, you know, one thing that just kills me is that you very rarely see a flag on them. It's so rare, it's not even funny. They just... You have to wonder if they ever put a flag on those flagpoles. I mean, did they? I mean, who knows? I mean, what if they never even, on most buildings, never even put a flag on them at all? I mean, I don't even know where to look. You got portholes here. You got these big pictures, you can just get lost in them. And you can look around and find some goodies. Central Trust Campus. Okay, I don't know what that is. That building right there is sick. That's pretty. I just heard an owl hooting outside my house here. A hootie owl. Look at those big old ether pieces right there. This is something, a phenomenon that I believe is part of the system, is that from my research, when I find these obelisks like this, as an example, they always seem to have, at least when they're first installed or first constructed, quote unquote, they seem to have four of these light fixture thing towers of some sort, lamps, one on the four corners. Okay, they always seem to have that. Now you'll go back and do research on your local obelisk. Okay, and you'll see, oh wait, they don't have them. But then if you go do some digging, it's very possible you're going to dig up the fact that they did have them originally. And I've got a really good example of that I'm holding on to for a project I'm working on. And I'll bring that out at some point. And I'm going to prove that, you know, how horseshit that idea really is with those. There's some underground right there. You can see it dropping down into the underground because they all like there's some more going underground. I think these are mole people and they like to live underground with their pavement light right here, 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 here. Got Fred's cousins at work. Yep. Horses and carts dragged us in, y'all. Circa 1910, St. James Hotel, Utica, New York. And what are we going to find? Oh, there's a Mudflood window. Woo! There's another Mudflood window. Double woohoo! And we got a big-ass door for middle midget people. Old world radiator. I believe that these are from the old world, the radiator systems. I believe the steam systems are old world. Big old arches. That's pretty. St. James Hotel with his Mudflood windows. I believe fire hydrants are old world. Check that out. That's interesting. I wonder what that is. Looks like something right in there. Hard to tell though. Bum bum bum. At their antenna. Hey, mercury ball. That's wow. That right there is just really cool. How they do these. These are just pretty to me. The way they do that. It's just so over the top. So unnecessary. And that is not done by, you know, Mexican migrant worker labor. You know, and I'm not saying the Mexican migrants can't make nice stuff, arc light. What I'm saying is this is highly knowledgeable labor. These are skilled workers. Pyramid right here and here. These are skilled workers. Okay, pyramid. Skilled workers built this. Highly skilled workers, not average everyday laborers. It's easy to lay brick, okay? You lay a brick, okay? You put down mortar. You lay another brick, you put down mortar. You lay a brick, put down mortar. Whatever. You level it out. You tap it out. Whatever. Okay. It's easy to lay a brick wall. Easy. Okay? It is. Let's just be honest. Once you got it, you got it. It's just time consuming. It takes time. It takes physical labor. But a monkey can do it, okay? Mr. Contractor could build him a wall out of bricks, okay? He's got that, no problem. But, Mr. Contractor, you didn't build that. I don't think so. I really don't. February 1940, courthouse and auto transport hauling Buicks in Chillicothe, Ohio. I just butchered that. Never heard of that. Chillicothe. No idea. I hope I didn't just butcher that. I probably did. I'm not good with names. It's like a kryptonite. That's a weird contraption. Weird. Okay. And we're just checking out this old world building here. That is pretty. Taurus fields. Pyramid. Clocks. This is the wind catcher right here. Probably your mercury ball with your ether finial. Ether antennas up there. Can't see a whole lot there, but that building really is something else. Can't see a whole lot of detail there, but that is pretty cool. And we got February 23rd, 1912, 3-ton electric sign blown into Broadway. Okay, so this is in New York. And the sign they're talking about is right here. And this is a one of two pictures I'm going to show you. There's an old world fire hydrant. Look at that detail. My goodness. Look at that wrought iron work. That's Capisces right there. That is just amazing. There's the coin right there with a Q. These look like they have been closed off to me. So the sign was up on top of the building and it got knocked down. It got arched windows there. And that's windows into the underground right there. Horseshit sign right there. We built that. I mean, who built what? Well, we built that horseshit sign that fell off the building. Okay, we got that worked out. There's ventilation in the underground right there. Okay, you got a Taurus field right there. Okay, and this is the second picture. And the first thing that popped into my mind was you got pavement light right here. And pavement light right here. And there's your underground. That is a trap door that opens up. Sometimes these had lifts. Sometimes they had stairs right here. They still use them today. You know, that's how they do their storage. Check out that big old portholes right there. Big old building back there. We've looked at that one before in these MUDDIN videos. These guys are like, damn, we don't know how to make nothing. We better call Mr. Contractor, have Mr. Contractor build us another sign because we broke this one. Look at those old ether lights right there, back in the background there, right there. Pretty. Jeez. So anyways, you can see, I'm going back to this picture, there's pavement light all across here. Okay, there's your pavement light. And there's the sign. So all this has got underground in it. That just goes to show you, you know, when you look closer, there's more there. Game of Craps, Cincinnati, Ohio in 1908. And I just thought this was a nice Mudflood picture for you, you know, enjoyment. Fella taking him a break in a Mudflood window. Good for you, my friend. And he knows that we're going to see him one day holding on to the evidence of the Mudflood. And he's busted. And he's mad about it. I'd be mad too if I knew that I was going to get busted for hanging out on a Mudflood evidence. I'm just saying. We got January 18th, 1917, New York Municipal Lodging House. And that is a flat earth asterisk right there with a diamond symbology in the center. So you got your vertical, your horizontal, and your X. You got Mudflood windows right here. These men, I guess, are waiting to get into the, what I'm assuming is a, I'm guessing, I'm talking out the left ass cheek here, but I think this is kind of like a homeless shelter of some sort. But I'm not positive. This, I could be wrong on that. Correct me if I'm wrong. Please let me know. I've never heard it called a municipal lodging house, but there's a reason that I think that it is that. And there's your flat earth asterisk. That's a straight on shot of what we just looked at. Yeah. And I can see Mudflood winners over on the other side of the street too. So there's your coin right there. Okay. I mean, this is a miserable lot here. They're ready to get inside. Okay, anyways, June 13th, 1911, cakewalk at Luna Park on Coney Island. And it's just another one of them quackadoodle Coney Island rides. I don't know what this one did. other than possibly as you're walking up this thing, that it moved. Kind of like in a funhouse today. But I really don't know. I'm guessing. Because it looks like people are just walking over it. And that doesn't seem interesting or fun, but maybe it had something to do with it moving. Because you see how it's separated here? It's separated here. Possibly separated there and there. I don't know. It might move back and forth kind of like a funhouse. I don't know. I don't know about that one. But I just thought it was interesting. I thought I'd share it. The witching waves. Yeah, so that's weird. I don't even know. What do you say about that? I'm not even sure. Portholes. I believe Coney Island's old world. June 16th, 1908, Metropolitan Life Tower under construction in New York City. And I believe that's that business up there. And we got Mr. Statue here. Got Fred here on the job getting to, he's doing taxi service today. There's the Pooper Scooper Man's cart, in case you're a Pooper Scooper follower. For whatever reason, that would be interesting to you. And got pretty wrought iron work. Arched winders. Horseshit signage. Mr. Contractor got the job on that one, no doubt. Big old ether antennas. All over the place. Oh my gosh, a flag on a flagpole. Wow. So this is being constructed here, supposedly. Okay. We've looked at this building before. It has clocks in here. Very interesting view. And that is... Look at this, how they're, this, that's what they're calling scaffolding. God, that's sketchy. Oh my gosh. Oh, hell no. Y'all. No. Yeah, I mean, who's to say? I mean, just putting an idea out there, because this is how we get to the bottom of things sometimes, is that who's to say this building wasn't already here, okay? And we decided to come in if it was done up to a certain point. Because, I mean, you got to think about this now. If you got this old world, right, and they got all these buildings, there's going to be construction projects lying around. They're not all going to be finished buildings. Who's to say that this building right here is not an unfinished old world construction product? Project, and we came in and finished it out. We might even be going by the blueprints that they had drawn up. Who knows? It's possible. Just something to think about. I'm not saying it is. I don't know the history of this building in particular, but I mean, it's just something to think about. And it's not just saying, I'm not just saying about this building. I'm saying a lot of these construction projects. We got Ether Finial right there. That's that same one that's on the Ponce de Leon Hotel in Florida. And that's just sick right there. A porthole. Man. That's the Parthenon. Oh, man. Look at this wind catcher up here. Amazing. Look at those ether finials up here. They're pulling the ether with that. And they just get the free energy out of air. You know, it's been hidden from us, people. It's all around us. March 1942, Helena, Montana, now playing at the Marlowe Sullivan's Travels and Paris Calling. Okay, I guess that's what they're talking about. Okay. Whoop-de-hoo-hoo. Got a coal hole cover there. Let's see, what are we gonna find in Helena. That's kind of weird looking, that whole business there. That's kind of odd right there. Can't say what I'm seeing, but it's interesting. That's pretty right there. Da-da-da. A lot of ups and downs on the flow here. Interesting. It's very possible there's pavement light right there. Can't say for sure, but I've seen pavement light looking like that before. Oh, we got a bank. The banks always like the big buildings. Mudflood Winders. That could be pavement light right there. This whole business here. Right, all that right there could be pavement light. Yep. That's pretty. Incredible. What a world. Oh, we got another bank. Of course. At the Finials. Over here. It's a weird symbol. It's like a Vesica Pisces with a Taurus field. Strange. And I have found from my research that a lot of the weirder things you see are in the smaller places. I guess it's because they didn't have as much money to cover it up or people to cover it up. And like things slipped through the cracks or people were more willing to just, you know, turn a blind eye to things or. But some of these smaller places, these smaller towns, are actually pretty cool to look at because you get to see things that kind of get overlooked in our world. Mr. Henry Gifford's balloon at the Tuileries, 1878. So for you dirigible and balloon enthusiasts, this is a cool one. Okay, it looks like a standard big-ass balloon, right? But and okay, this from this picture, you can't really tell what's going on, okay? But I'm going to show you something that's going to trip you out. If you ain't ever seen this before, it's going to trip you out. We're going to go to the next picture first. Boom. This is a close-up. What do you think of that? I don't even have the words. It's just, I don't even know where to start. Where do you start with that? That is on a level of I'm wordless there. I don't know what to say about that. The portholes all over that thing back there. Portholes there. That is incredible. How many people we got on this thing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. At least 28 people. I mean, how in the shit? Look at the rigging on that thing. I mean, that is incredible. Let me go back. Okay, that's what you're looking at. Okay. See? Look at this. I mean, that, you know what? I mean, I mean, does this thing go like wherever it wants or does it just go up in the air? Because if it goes up in the air, like, have you ever seen a hot air balloon land? I know this isn't I don't believe this is a hot air balloon. I could be wrong, but I don't believe this is a hot air balloon. Okay, let's say this is a helium balloon. But have you ever seen a hot air balloon land? Okay, now I'm going to tell you from this, my personal experience. There's a hot air balloon company that runs out here in the country. out where I am. And it's got a big old bear on the balloon. Anyways, this thing, they've been running it for a long time. And they use the fields across the street from where I live in order for a place to land. Sometimes they have, I guess, deals worked out with people around this area that they can land in certain places. And I have seen them land quite a few times in across the street from where I am. But I have never, ever seen them land in exactly the same spot. They land damn near anywhere that thing will land. Because it's got a mind of its own. So you got this thing that's purposely built. I'm getting to the point. You got this thing that's obviously purposely built for this balloon, right? Well, if they let this thing fly away, it ain't coming back to that spot. Ain't a Chinaman's chance in hell that that happened. Okay, it's not going to happen. So it probably just goes straight up in the air. That's my theory. And I'm sticking to it. I don't know if it's true or not. I don't know if this thing may fly off anywhere it wants. I don't know, but I don't think it does. I think it stays right where it is and goes up in the air. Even though I'm not really seeing the ropeage to hold it. I mean, is that the ropeage to hold it? I don't know. I don't know. That is freaking wild, man. And what is this shit back in the background with its portholes and its mudflood windows? What is that? I don't even know. I just don't even know. It's crazy talk. There's Fred. He's back there building. You know? That's what Fred does. Fred does what Fred does. I mean, it's just so weird. I mean, what? I mean, look at this cable system right here. This looks like it holds it down, right? Look how big those cables are. Or ropes. Can't tell if they're cables or ropes. I would imagine in 1878 it would have to be ropes. That's my guess. I'm not seeing... I don't know. I don't know. I'm moving on. Y'all figure it out. New York, 1908. Old church on 48th Street. Studebaker Garage. A former Christian Science house of worship at 143 West 48th Street. That's a lot of information to be thinking about. And for the people that follow the poop on the ground, there is some poop for you. Just so you have some for your collection of wanting to see that. I don't know why. Anyways, that's Boss Man right there. And we've got Underground, in case you need Underground in your mud flood research. And we've got more Underground. And more Underground. Lots of Underground. Plenty of Underground. A coal hole cover. Yep, got some hoodlums. Yep. Definitely. And we've got Florida Lee. Florida Lee's not French. Sorry, French. The Florida Lee is not your symbol. Got mudflood winders down here. Mudflood coal hole covers. More mudflood winders. Arched winders. Beautiful ass stained glass. Oh my goodness. Toilette. A lot of times you see the toilette. It's got basements. Look at the. This is 1908. And the paint is peeling on the off the brick there. That's interesting. Phoenician shell with Phoenician waves. It's a rose style window. And that's supposed to be a Studebaker garage. So this is supposedly an old church. But by 1908, they just turned it into a garage. So we just pull our cars in right here into the big ass church door. I can't make this shit up. I'm sorry. But what is this? I just don't even. Oh my gosh. Who's making this narrative up? I think it would have been fun to work in the narrative department of the elite mudflood cover-up division. You know, can you imagine being able to write the horseshit stories? How much fun that would be? New York, 1917. Landship recruit on Union Square. Oh, this is going to be good. The USS recruit. A wooden battleship erected by the Navy served as a World War I recruiting station at Union Square from 1917 to 1920 when it set sail for Coney Island. So they picked this sucker up. This is a wood mock-up of a battleship, and then they picked it up, moved it to Coney Island. Oh my God. And then there's pavement light. Well, this must be right in front of City Hall. City Hall must be to the left or right here, or that's the subway runs under this right here. That's pavement light going to this, and there's more pavement light right there. But what the hell's going on here? This is insanity. Look at these buildings. I mean, they're just incredible. Mr. Contractor, did you build that? Be honest with yourself. Be honest with us, because we think you're lying. You might as well just tell us the truth. It's like, you know, Mr. Contractor, you want us to believe whatever you want, the horse shit you come up with. And I'm going to just tell you, we don't believe it. We're aware. We're awake now. So your horse shit does not work on us anymore. That's Morris Building. You know, the horseshit narrative that you believe, and it just doesn't work anymore. So your Jedi voodoo ain't working, okay? Your mind control tricks, you know, are no longer working on us aware and awake folk. So, you know, I would go and get you a big old cup of wake the fuck up, and you know, pull your head out of the mud flood, Mr. Contractor. I think Mr. Contractor built that. I think we got evidence that Mr. Contractor, Mr. Stick Builder built that right there. I think that's evidence of Mr. Contractor's work right there. Mr. Contractor, we'd like you to build a battleship in the middle of this park so we can recruit men to go off to a war that is supposedly to fight a country that is being a bad boy, when in reality it is actually a cover-up destruction of mud flood buildings. And, you know, in the process, we're going to quell the population by getting people shot up. And that'll help, you know, with some of the overpopulation, because we have not decided that eugenics is working well enough yet. And if you don't know what eugenics are, you might want to go do some research on the word eugenics. Just saying. But do what you want. And that is a battleship in the middle of a park in New York in 1917. This is New York in 1908. Italian Fiesta. Mott Street, decorated for religious feast. Religious feast. So, what are we feasting on? Beans? I don't know. What is this? Candy. Ooh. I like candy. Nah, I don't eat too much candy. I've never been like real big on candy. I like candy, but not, you know, super duper. Why am I selling you this? Who cares? Anyways, got purtiness. Just look at the purtiness underneath this horseshit fire escape. You could tell what we made. You know, if it looks like junk, if it looks crappy, okay, we built it. Okay, it's real simple. There's two different people constructing this view here. You got it's like lipstick on a pig, okay? But we're the pig, okay? The lipstick is the building, okay? And we're the pig. And there's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. And he does change colors, by the way. Just saying. He's got it like that. And there's entrances to the mud flood underground right there, store and basement to let. Okay, arc light right there. Alrighty, some kind of religious feast. Okay, I do not see any religions represented here. Unless I'm missing it. Gentile Brothers. Okay. There's a little bit there. That's interesting. I don't know. Anyways, October 9th, 1914, watching the first game of the 1914 World Series from rooftops overlooking Schneeb Park in Philadelphia. I probably just butchered that. Excuse me, Philadelphians. And I just find this interesting that people are sitting on the roof of this place to watch a game. I find that very fascinating. Almost looks like they have built bleachers up here, which is even more fascinating. Ready money. Okay. Smokestacks that ain't smokestacks. We made them smokestacks. No doubt. I mean, it's just a weird damn picture right here. I ain't never seen nothing like, I mean, people just hanging out on the roofs. Oh, what in the world? I just don't even know what to do there. I just, oh, okay. Here we're getting down to something. What you got there, fella? Got underground right there. Got something underground there. Got some underground business there. Yep. Mm-hmm. I think that's Boss Man right there. Hey, what a weird picture. What's going on down here? They're supposed to be watching the 1940. How are you going to watch the World Series? I mean, maybe there's, maybe it's really open right here. Maybe. I'm assuming it is, but I mean, like, I don't know. It's just odd. Freaking weird, man. Some of the shit they do. There's another phenomenon that I've noticed in this time frame that I can't put my finger on it. It's just very strange. And that is people climbing and watching events like sporting events or parades in the trees. And they climb up in the trees, and there's quite a few pictures of men or boys in the trees. I mean, and I don't mean a few feet off there. I mean 20, 30, 40 feet in the air. Up in a tree, and they're hanging out watching something, and there'll be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 guys in one tree. And I have run across this over and over again. And an example, I put out a video yesterday, Santa Claus parades, my Christmas video this year. So if you want a little Christmas cheer, go watch that. Might put a smile on your face. But in that video, somewhere in the middle, there's in the background, you've got some fellas in the background up in the trees, hanging out in the trees, watching the parade. And it, you know, first glance, it don't, you know, that's okay. Some guys climb a tree to watch a parade, but no, there's something to it. Because think about it. When's the last time you saw somebody climb 20, 30, 40 feet up in a tree? And this is a regular occurrence back in this time frame. So why were they doing it back then and we don't do it today? I mean, I know why we don't do it today, because we're not idiots. We don't climb trees that high because we know that we're going to fall out, break our damn necks. But why back then did they not know that? You have to think that they knew that that was probably stupid, but they did it anyways. Why? Richmond, Virginia again, 1865, showing the burned district along with the James River. And we're going to see all the burned out houses from where they blew up the city. Because they say, the Union's coming, the Union's coming. Uh-huh. Does that look like a burned out city, or does that look like a do attack? I'm just saying. Look at the portholes on that one. All across there. There's Fred. Fred is the one who had to come and pick up the bricks after they were knocked down. Poor Fred. He's so overworked. This is weird right here. mean, look at that. That is the we got one level here and another level here. That's some weirdness there, man. That's mud floody looking right there. This area here. It's got a mud flood look to it. And these old world chimneys, what we call chimneys, these were part of the air conditioning systems, that the wind catching systems of the homes. That's what they were. We used them as chimneys and burned a bunch of houses down. We realized that they did not work well as chimneys. That was probably, you know, you go back and study the history of chimneys, and they had a lot of trouble with chimneys in the beginning. They didn't know how to use them. Those look like mud flood windows right there. Hard to tell, but that's what it looks like. That's the James River, obviously. Let's see. So anywho, pictures are in the description. Go do your own looking. Petersburg, Virginia courthouse, 1865. From photographs of the main Eastern Theater of War, the Siege of Petersburg, June 1864 through 1865. Okay. Oh, gaslight. That probably had a pulley in it for bringing up the hay right into the loft here. More than likely. There's something going on right there. This kind of looks suspect to me, this area here. It starts at one level and it gets lower and lower and lower. That looks mud flooded to me. Kind of hard to tell what's going on there exactly, but wholesale shoe house. Okay. Maybe Diana. Clocks are expensive. So this would be part of the wind catcher, I imagine, or this. Probably this. Got a bell in this one. Pyramid symbology. Big ass door. That tree looks wild. It looks like it's swirling. Trippy, man. Trippy. Okay. That's about it for that. And we've got Washington, 1863. Mess hall at the Harewood Hospital. Heated and elaborate stoves. Are heated by elaborate stoves. Speak English much? And I want to show this because of these stoves. Because these things are, you know, what in the world, man? I mean, that is old world tech right there. I don't know what the world. I mean, what? You know. I don't know what they're putting out. You know, anybody that knows anything about wood stoves knows that you don't want to take more than 290 degree turns on a wood stove because it messes up your airflow. So this has got 190 degree and 290 degree, but why didn't they just straight pipe it up? Maybe it's to, so it goes up, the heat stays in the building longer. That's possible. Interesting though, these, you know, I mean, and look at this room. I mean, look how shitty this room is. It's not even finished on the walls. Look at that. Yet they have these amazing freaking heaters. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them in this room. I mean, is that not odd? I don't know. It's just very strange. I mean, this thing's got gas light. Or I don't even know if that's gas. No, that's not even gas. That's just the oil lamp. They don't even have a gas light in here. I don't think that's... No, that's not gas. That's oil light. What the hell? I don't know. Freaking weird. Washington, D.C. banker and Bon Viant. What the hell does that mean? Eddie Voigt in a pimped out Abbott Detroit Roadster circa 1920. Pimped out. Okay, I guess he's pimped out. God, that guy reminds me of a guy I knew a long time ago. Wow. This guy's name was Jim, but we called him Vinny because he looked like a Guido. And he looked just like that dude. That's hilarious. Oh, man. Good times. Okay. Let's see what we got here. Some kind of weird frames there. I don't know. Mudflood Winders. Boss man right there, Mudflood Winders. And we're going to look for Mudflood. I'm going to find it. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America, in case you weren't aware of that. Diamond symbology there. Let's see. Wow, that's cool. Look at that right there. What in the world? I mean, how do you even come up with that? I don't even know. That's just another next level stuff there. I don't even know. They don't have AutoCAD back then, people. Ether finials up here, ether antenna. Yeah, probably a wind catcher there, ether finials. I don't know. Okay, moving on. Washington, D.C., circa 1860s, old Winder building, 17th and F Street, Northwest. Got some barrels, gas lights. These are probably mud flutters back here, because, well, if you see stairs going up, there's probably mud below. I'm just saying. And there's mud flood windows on the bottom of that building there. Look at that horseshit step right there. What's that about? Look at these mudflood winders. Look, see how the winders are. Look at that. I mean, look, they're even digging out the mud here. I mean, good grief, they're digging out the mud. Oh God, there it is. There's the. Oh, what the hell? Seriously? Come on, y'all. Seriously, you're not even trying to hide it no more. There's your Mudflood Winders, in case you need some of them. There's Fred back there. He's the horse to build America, in case you need to know who hauled all this brick around. Look at that facade peeling off, and there's brick underneath. So you get up under that lady's skirt, and there's brick under there. So in 1860s, okay, in the 1860s, this building is already falling apart. The 1860s. Already in ruins. Think about that. When was this building built? I'm just saying, that's a big, I mean, it ain't the most decorative building, but it is a well-built, strong building, and why would you let it go to waste? Why would you let it fade away? Why would you just let it fall apart? Ether antenna and Washington, D.C., circa 1917, National Photographic Company office at 815 H Street Northwest. And what can we find? That's interesting. There's Fred right there. Fred is behind that cart right there. Fred is working. Fred is the horse that built America, in case you didn't know. Done told you something you didn't know. And we got Mudflood Underground Doors Winters right here, in case you need some of that. More mudflood. You want mudflood? I'll give you mudflood. You want it? I'll give it to you. Okay, I got it all. I'll give it to you. I don't mind sharing with my friends. I tell you, you guys, this community has been very, very supportive of what I'm doing here. You know, when I started this out, I I really didn't think that anybody was even going to give a damn or care or believe that I had anything to say. So I appreciate every one of you. I've almost got 3,000 subs now. Woohoo! I'm a small fry. But, you know, I started this thing out and never intended it to be what it has become. Sorry I left you on a tree. So I really appreciate every one of you for taking your time to listen to me run my mouth. And I hope that I give you some value. And I hope I add something to your research and your thinking. And I really appreciate every one of you. And I'll continue doing what I do if you'll continue supporting me and showing up and watching the videos and taking, you know, giving me your time. I really appreciate it all. And we got Washington, D.C. in 1920, Hans Shoe Store at 7th and K Streets Northwest. And we got some repair men doing some work here. Working men on the job. And what we're going to find? Show me something. Ghost Man. Right there. Horseshit scaffolding. Okay, look very closely at that scaffolding. That is our work. See that? That is our capabilities. We can build that. Okay? You see how unhigh-tech that is? How probably unsafe that is? And this fellow's over here working on that. No, I don't think so. Tartarian lions. Yeah, I said it. Dollar and the kitty. Scrubbed cartouche. This is interesting. You know, is this an old world cartouche here, or is this, you know, a modified new world? I don't know. It's hard to say. This lettering on the front is definitely our stuff. But I can't say that piece is not old world. This is interesting. Look at the glass here and look at the glass here. What's going on there? And these look scrubbed to me. These circles. Phoenician wave. There's the Phoenician lady. Got a tourist field here. Obviously, we wrote the word Hans on the side of this building because that looks right. Clocks are expensive. Looks like something scrubbed off of here and here. I got an ether antenna up there. Another one over here. Porthole. Ether antenna. That's a weird one. Goldbergs. Look at these ether fencings right here. Interesting. Look at that brickwork right there. Woo. So weird to see all these windows open, you know. We don't see windows open these days. They didn't have air conditioning, you know. I mean, it was a whole different bag. See the awnings covering the big ass doors? It just takes away. They didn't want you to see that. We see it now, though. Washington, D.C., circa 1920, Northern Liberty Market, Convention Hall Market at 5th and K. And that is just beautiful. I have to say. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America, in case you need to know who that is. Florist, ether antenna. We obviously built this shed roof here, you know, and we got these big ass arches right here. Rose window. What a building. Wow. Look at that. Whoa. Mr. Contractor, build me one of them, please, would you? If you don't mind. I know it's something simple for you, dude. You can do everything. You're Super Mr. Contractor. Super Mr. Contractor can build a Tartaria building in a flash. I really am not a singer. Okay, yeah, those stairs are horseshit. Definitely horseshit. Look at the grade on those steps. I mean, you're basically going to break every neck in your body falling down that. I'm just saying. Look at how big that door is compared to that midget woman right there. Woman in uniform, by the way. And another smokestack that ain't a smokestack. It's probably, you know, output for a wind catcher. At the Benson, at the Benials, Arclight. Those stairs are just absolute horseshit. We definitely added this covered area here. No doubt. We added the whole front to that right there. Everything on the front of that is just take that away. That's not what the front looked like. Look how much uglier that building looks because you got that shit on the front. Anyways, it's been fun. It's been real fun. Beaks out.
With your eyes fixed to the floor, sounded that go down the street by the monument. Man was screaming through a megaphone. Get your hands out the Middle East. Every word would hurt the cynical. Every word would cut your teeth. You wake up. Seen down in the capital, all the suits in clattered feet. Sue rats will shiny underground in a ways to make ends meet. From the screen keeps a keen eye on the in-between, from the people to the queen.
Play God. woof again! Say woof again!
I've got one that can see.
Welcome to the underground.
Ja, bei bin.
Oh, awesome. Oh, what the? Check, is showing real time with his arrow.
This is my kung fu, and it is strong.
See you later.